How does someone politely end a conversation with a person who won't stop talking? I'm an Uber driver. I was once summoned to pick up two people for just this reason. They had me drive 4 blocks/0.25 miles/1.5 minutes to another bar, just to get out of a conversation with someone. Minimum fare, $3.75, and $10 tip on the app. I would gladly tip $10 to get me out of a terrible inescapable conversation. Just curious, did the app add the $10, or did they choose to tip that amount? The tip is voluntary and user set. Else it would not be a tip, it'd be the price. US restaurants beg to differ. The infuriating suggested tip request. I've gone to places that literally add the tip and tell you how much it was. I read one of those mildly interesting newspaper features recently with an etiquette expert. Their advice was, rather than make an excuse, you should be more direct, that you are ending the conversation, and say something, like I've really enjoyed talking with you, I'm going to circulate around the room now as it's less likely to create an expectation you might come back. It does work too. I'm going to circulate around the room now, even better if, A, you're in a park, B, you're trapped in your cubicle at work, C, you're beginning hospice and the nurse is going over the care plan. One of these is not like the others. Yeah, what's all this flap about having a job? And your own cube to boot. Lucky devil. I'd kill for a cube at this point. My company just moved offices and we're in open concept, super close quarters seating arrangement. I feel like everyone is breathing down my neck and my chair hits the person behind me's chair all the time. We are so close together. Worst case I've ever had, I basically gave every verbal cue I knew of, eventually stood up, then stood in the doorway, then backed out of the doorway, and this dude was still talking. In the end I just said I'll be back, and closed the door on him mid-sentence. My dad's like this. When I was a kid/teenager he'd follow me to every room of the house talking. If I went to the bathroom he'd stand outside, and continue talking to me through the door. If I had to leave, like to go to school, I would literally leave the house and he'd stand in the doorway, and continue talking as I walked down the path and out of sight. He still does this when I go back home to visit. It wouldn't be so bad if he'd actually be willing to have a conversation. But he only talks at you. If you try and say anything, he just talks over you, as if you haven't said a thing. Eater, so far in the replies my dad has been armchair diagnosed with autism, bipolar disorder, hypermanic disorder, narcissistic personality disorder and goodness knows what else. He doesn't have a mental illness. He talks a lot. It's just a quirk, and I wouldn't have him any other way. If I could also stop being accused of not loving him/appreciating him, and being told I'll miss him when he's dead, that'd be grand. I'm annoyed. I don't mean to interrupt, but it's got to be done, so just do it. They need a break anyway. This is the right answer. You simply need to interrupt them, apologize for doing so, and let them know you need to do something else. Which is still a little awkward, because I don't actually have something else to do. I just want to do nothing without having to listen to them. Just because you don't have other plans for your time, does not mean other people are entitled to have your time. I hate to disturb you, of course, he expressed, he begged for forgiveness, and stared at him stressed. I hate to disturb you, he said to him pained, it's just that you won't fucking stop, he explained. I have to return some videotapes. But Blockbuster closed years ago, continues talking. Oh no, Blockbuster didn't have these videotapes winks. Wait, then how did you get them, continues talking. Welp. Looks like I'm going back to anger management classes. We have a great line that we use in Ireland. I haven't heard it used abroad, but it could well be used all over for all I know. The person is rabbiting on and is showing no sign of stopping. You clearly and firmly say I'll let you go. Then with the confidence of a person doing them a favor you turn on your heel and stride away. This has the effect of making them think you are the one wanting to avoid wasting their time. If they figure it out, they can't call you out on it, because to do so would be to admit, at least to themselves, that they are wasting your time. In fact, most people never allow themselves to think it might be them who is holding you up, so they accept the offer of your leaving in order for them to get on with their important work. In general, if someone says I'll let you go to me, rare but it has happened, I smile and say bye and end the conversation. It is a social convention and I abide by it. They want out. No ego. Let them go, and the best of luck to them. People appreciate that, I imagine. We have something like that in Germany, that translates to I don't want to keep you any longer. Edit, the phrase is ich werde dich nicht länger aufhalten. For everyone who was wondering which phrase I'm talking about. The problem with that is 9 times out of 10 the people talking on and on at you will say, oh I have plenty of time, and you're still screwed. Ahh. In my experience, you have to be firm and walk off. It's all about confidence in the move. 8 in my head out. Leave zone house. FR though depending on the situation slash relationship it can send a hilariously clear message. 8 in my head out, but it's your place. Yup. And was getting a little chummy. When people get too chummy with me, I like to call them by the wrong name, to let them know I don't really care, Ron Swanson. I don't know who this Ron Swanson guy is, but I like him. In a non-sexual way, of course. You must be his best friend, then. You guys still never talk sometimes? I realize in the past my favorite friends and family members are usually the ones who don't call me, and don't want anything. If they do get in touch, it's because they realize they stumbled onto something they know I'd really be interested in. Non-communicative best friends are the best. You know they have your back, even when you haven't paid the social dues others demand in exchange for their trust and friendship.